understand, Joe. I just don't think I can handle your drinking or this marriage anymore. Can you turn that down, please?
Maddie, why we always gotta be arguing about stuff? If it's not about money, it's about my job. Or about my drinking. Or you accusing me of having a girlfriend. Sometimes I wish I had a girlfriend, just to give you a good enough reason to start an argument.
13 years is long enough, Joe. I've tried. I really have. I just can't do this anymore.
Why are you so eager to end this? What's going on that you're not telling me? This has got to be about more me drinking beer.
I don't think I can love you the way you want me to anymore, Joe.
What is going on with us, Maddie? I love you. Give us another chance.
I just can't do this anymore, Joe.
I know we can work things out, Maddie. I'm not ready to let you go.
Joe, I'm sorry. It's over.
Will make a difference?
You scared me. I didn't hear you walk up. But no, these flowers aren't going to make a difference to anybody. I wasn't able to attend their funeral, so this is my way of paying my respects.
So you believe you've had ample time to think about the pain you've caused?
Yeah. 5 years in prison. How can I forget? Do I know you?
We met once, but we never talked, so no. You don't really know me, and I really don't know you. Are you asking them to forgive you in the hopes that you can forget? If so, I think your hopes may be far from reach.
Who are you?
It's not important.
I paid my debt to society for my actions. But you're saying I can never be forgiven.
So you think roses will heal the wounds of the past?
No, never. Over the last 5 years, I've had plenty of time to think about what I could possibly do to make amends.
I'm most curious, what became of those thoughts?
I thought maybe me being 6 foot under would have been better for everybody. I should have died that night too. That would have been the easy way out.
Certainly very selfish of you.
Selfish? Yeah, selfish. Then I wouldn't have had to think about all the pain I've caused. The pain I've caused them, my wife Maddie, their families, my family. I never wanted this to happen. I just wish I could let them know that.
Somehow I think they know. Most men run from their mistakes, others hide from them. A real man faces them.
I can only offer what I have in my heart. Regret, sorrow, guilt. I wish I could turn back the hands of time, but I can't.
I believe you're sincere in your regret and sorrow. You seem to be a good man. I've let go of the hatred I felt towards you, and now I can only wish you peace. But I'm here to tell you, you will be haunted forever.
So, as long as I'm haunted, I'm forgiven. Why would you hate me? Oh, you knew them. I'm sorry.
The reason for my hatred is not important. I've learned to let go of it. You must learn to live with the guilt for the pain and suffering you have caused. It is not up to me to forgive you.
Fair enough.
Hey, how did you... Hello? Hello? Forgive myself.
Thank you.
We were on our way home from church when suddenly a car came across the center line straight at us. The last thing I remember was my wife and daughter screaming.
I was talking with Sarah about her field trip. And then Sam hit the brakes hard and yelled. Next thing I knew, there were headlights coming straight at us. And then I felt the pain.
Joe was drinking quite a lot. It cost him his job. That caused us to argue about money. And his drinking. I at least tried to get him to stop drinking and driving, but he just wouldn't listen. I knew better than to get in that car, but I did it anyway.
Yeah, I had choices to make, and I made the wrong ones. Why was I driving? Maddie always begged me to stop driving when I was drinking. I wouldn't listen, I was fine, I could handle it. I took the lives of four innocent people. My beautiful wife, Maddie, thought I'd just only listen to her. And family. Little girl. Don't feel sorry for me. I'm not a victim. I'm the one to blame. I'm the criminal. Hopefully, you'll never become a victim. If you make the right choice, you won't become a killer like me.
We were on our way home from church. Me and Mom were talking about the school field trip I was going on the next day. Then she screamed. Really loud. I missed the field trip. I hope my friends had fun. Is there grass in heaven?